Hey guys, today we're going to rank up the strongest known creatures from the Supernatural franchise. So without further delay, let's get started. While the show was highly centered around the battle between heaven and hell, the entire premise from the start of the series rested on the fact that the boys were hunters, and they hunted all manner of creatures ranging from the classic myths to some really evil, more advanced and powerful creations. Dating back to the first season of Supernatural, which featured some legendary myths, from the tales of the Woman in White and the legendary Bloody Mary, to Wendigos and Poltergeists. From there, the hit CW series kept raising the stakes, making every ghost or ghoul even more powerful than the last. And soon enough, some alpha monsters were introduced into the Supernatural series. And not long after, we got to see the first archangel, known famously as the Yellow-Eyed Demon, who gave us a taste of what true power looked like. Considering the amount of monsters from bloodsuckers to shapeshifters to horrific monsters and powerful demons, we decided to compile a list of the overall strongest villains the Winchester brothers have had to face throughout the franchise. For now, here are the 10 most powerful creatures in the Supernatural series. Number 10, the Alpha Vampire. From the Supernatural series, we got to see quite a lot of mythical creatures, and not surprising, the majority of them have an alpha, who is technically the first creature in their class, and they are usually the most powerful of them all. But among those other alphas, one stands out as the most powerful alpha ever created, and that is the Alpha Vampire, the strongest of all vampires. He was the first vampire created, and from the show it was said that he existed long before humans learned how to make fire. The Alpha Vampire has the same abilities as the other vampires, but his abilities scale on a much higher level than the others due to his age and experience. And he is technically regarded as one of the most powerful monsters in history due to his alpha status. He was so strong that the only thing capable of killing this guy at the time was a redesigned version of the legendary Colt and its rare bullets. These raw facts of the Alpha Vampire definitely earns him a spot on our list. Number 9, Demons. Demons are technically souls who had the resilience needed to endure long periods of torture in hell before becoming an evil and extremely powerful reincarnation of the corrupt. We can't technically categorize demons into one class because there were quite many and possessed different abilities. But when it comes to strong creatures in the Supernatural series, demons must be included as some of the most powerful. In the show, we got to see a variety of demons like Lilith, who was the first demon, and soon after other powerful demons such as Azazel, now famously known as the Yellow-Eyed Demon, Dagon, Ramiel, and Asmodeus Rose. And then there was possibly the most powerful demon in Supernatural and a personal favorite called Crowley, a demon so powerful he once served as the king of hell. Yes, demons can actually be killed, but it is never an easy task to take them down. I always wondered, what happens to demons killed in hell? Do they stay in hell or disappear from existence? I guess we may never know. Number 8, Knights of Hell. Never knew hell needed knights? Well, apparently they do. Because the Knights of Hell are regarded as a set of advanced demons, specially bred and trained by Cain himself, long regarded as the original Knight of Hell. We can't estimate for sure how powerful they are, but we do know that they are the most powerful demons of hell. They are invulnerable to almost everything because only someone who possesses the mark of Cain and uses the first blade can hope to harm one of them. And it took the intervention from one of their own to take out most of the species, besides Abaddon, who managed to escape. In a way, you can call these guys the special task force of hell. At least, that's what we were made to believe from the series. Number 7, Angels. Although considering angels as creatures might be a bit wrong, that doesn't mean that they didn't prove to be more dangerous than any monster the Winchester brothers ever encountered. Originally, angels are tasked with maintaining the general well-being of heaven and protecting the souls of the good. But several angels did stray from the path of righteousness, and the results were catastrophic, at least from a human's point of view. An angel's powers comes from the amount of grace and wings they possess, and various classes of angels sitting below the archangels can still smite lesser beings easily, release holy white light as a weapon, negate lesser abilities, and much more. Not very many things can kill an angel, but the most efficient way was to use angel blades and also certain categories of higher ranking demons, leviathans, and of course, the first blade. Number 6, Horsemen of the Apocalypse. If you aren't quite familiar with the series or may have forgotten, well, the Winchester brothers did encounter these deities of apocalypse. The Four Horsemen of the Apocalypse, at least as the Bible puts it, consists of four deities called War, Famine, Pestilence, and Death. But among them, Death does stand out as the most powerful horseman. Being the oldest of all the horsemen, Death is regarded as invulnerable and unkillable. Only Death's scythe can kill Death and the other horsemen. But unlike the others, Death only dies a temporary death, because once a Death is killed, the next Reaper to die becomes the new Death, which was the case with Billy in Season 12 and the temporary Death in Season 15. Yeah, that was probably the most confusing thing you have ever heard. But that's Supernatural for you. And that's it for the most powerful creatures in the Supernatural franchise, places 10 to 6. Stay tuned for the next video, where we will talk about even more powerful creatures and our places 5 to 1. So, subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss out on that. And as always, thanks for watching.